Hello all newcomers and welcome back my fellow Aeternians. Yesterday I was on r/micronations when I ran into a peculiar post. In it, the author addresses the concern that many micronations are of a fantasy variety instead of realist, saying that it's no shame to have fun with your online friends running a pretend nation. It's just not micronationalism. And this took me by surprise because this person, whether knowingly or not, has accidentally stepped themselves right into the middle of one of the largest controversies in micronationalism. So here was my response. In this community, your idea is more popular than you think. However, I think it depends on your definition of micronationalism. I have run a YouTube channel based around my friends and family's development of a micronation over the last half decade. Most everyone I've run into has the same base definition for what a micronation is. A group which considers itself to be a nation, despite not being recognized as one by other currently recognized states, such as those in the UN. This means that despite how close someone is in their own mind to checking off the boxes of standard nation-building guides like the Montevideo Convention, until those states that are recognized by such a convention also recognize your nation, you have only a little more backing your claim than someone saying they claim all of North America. For example, one of the people who popularized using the Montevideo Convention as a method for micronation self-defining sovereignty is none other than Molossia's Kevin Baugh. He posits that because he declared Molossia as independent, it is, regardless of recognition, and that's that. Do you believe that Molossia and Kevin Baugh meet all of the requirements of this convention? Better yet, do you think he's concerned with meeting all of the requirements of this convention or being recognized at all? If you believe his claims are legitimate, that means his claims to still be fighting an active war against East Germany, a state that no longer exists, must also be legitimate. If Molossia is legitimate at that point, then it's hard for any micronation not to pass the bar, because many micronations that you would consider unrealistic or not up to par regularly make alliances and agreements with Molossia, simply by reaching out, some even specifically defined as recognition agreements. This means that, by Molossia's standard, they may be considered of a higher legitimacy than some other groups that do check off more of the boxes of the Montevideo Convention. If Molossia's claims are not legitimate, then there are much deeper ramifications for our community. If he cannot just declare Molossia independent because his territory claims are still controlled by the US, then many of even the most realistic of micronations must fall out of any hope of becoming recognized by the signing members of the Montevideo Convention, or this community. I think the bigger problem in the community is gatekeeping. We like to think that what we're doing is so unique and different and beneficial to the world or to the people we're trying to help that we feel the need to set boundaries around who fits to our standards. The fact is, before you start a nation, do you or did you go around reaching out to every micronation and macronation you could find, asking for their approval before beginning? More than likely not. If you did, you may unfortunately find that some have a stricter definition than you and may not allow you to create one. But isn't that wrong? If I were to guess, we all just created nations. Maybe even with some initial planning, but almost never because of the approval of others, but rather because for one reason or another, we felt it absolutely necessary for our survival or the survival of our families. If you don't feel it absolutely necessary for your survival to do so, then the only other reason for you to be doing it is for ambition. To seek the goal of a better tomorrow. Or ultimately, for fun. I consider Aeternia, the nation I'm from, to be a rather serious development. We just filmed a video walking around and talking to people in our area about Aeternia and micronations in general, and asking their opinions, explaining how we're starting to build shelters for people to live on our territory. Even those people who may not recognize us, may not consider us legitimate in any way, and may even be skeptical of our intentions, still were incredibly encouraging and vocally supportive of the idea. I think that the reason they go out on a limb and support us is because they know that even those ideas that may seem unrealistic or silly can still have incredibly real impacts on people's lives. If any micronation that claims to control half of Europe or is in some imagined war does even one tangible and beneficial thing for their community, then isn't it worthwhile for them to keep existing? What if those people one day decide that running a nation isn't for them, and they decide to become the citizen of another micronation. It could be your nation. But if those people are told by this community that what they're doing isn't real, that they aren't micronations, and they don't belong here, many of them will listen. The ones that leave will be replaced by a group of more aggressive trolls who do and say things to annoy you. The rest who leave will have been people who may have had unrealistic claims or ideas, but still cared passionately about this community and the belief that micronations are real and legitimate states and deserve to be recognized by the world as such. What's worse, those people who feel abandoned by this community may turn into its most hateful critics, such that when you go to more aggressively promote your own nation, you find a vocal minority who push back. These people may become purists, who believe that no micronation is legitimate, or that the idea of micronationalism itself is harmful and filled with extremist secessionist groups. The idea of that is something that can easily become the general consensus of the public, and something we should become very concerned about before the word micronation is seen as negative. So it may turn out that by gatekeeping as we do, we turn our most loyal supporters into our most dangerous opposition. I know the question specifically asks about internet-based nations, but my point is that saying something is or isn't a micronation becomes a very slippery slope. In the end, we can learn a lot from one another. And in all these attempts at statehood, we should see a commonality. We all start nations because we think we could do something better than what we have now. And we should support and encourage each other to live the lives that we want to. Be honest and open about your feelings if something looks inappropriate or steps on another nation's toes. But be supportive in your criticism. Thank you for being a part of this community and asking these questions. I look forward to learning more about how you've paved your own path and what it can teach us about ours. Because what you're doing and trying to achieve is legitimate and is real and is valid. And what those people are doing and their attempts are defined and validated not by you, not by me, not by anybody else, but by themselves. And that should be enough to be welcomed into this community and called an equal. We are micronations, we deserve to be recognized, and we support each other. Thank you. Aeternia forever.